Hey guys, it's Saru, and there is a brand new MMORPG that's on the horizon. It's going to be coming out very, very soon in the first half of 2023, and right now everybody can test it out. The game is called Reign of Guilds, so I'm going to talk a little bit about it, and then we're going to see what it's all about, and yeah, I'll give you my first impressions, because I got to play the playtest a little bit yesterday, so I'll have a little bit of an idea of what the game's going to be like. So, let's get right into it. Alright, so before I start, I do know that there are people that want me to talk about Quinfall. I know about Quinfall. I'm well aware about Quinfall, but the thing is I really don't have any interest in it whatsoever, because the quick information that I had learned, at least for Quinfall, like the entire company itself, the CEO literally started the company 6 months after getting out of college. The studio started in 2021, so that means pre-production and all that stuff had to start in 2021. It's only literally been 2 years, so even if they had started in January or February 2023, it's been 2 years, and that MMO is apparently coming out this year. So here's my thing, I have seen the video. I literally saw just endless assets that are being reused, and I know they're being reused because I literally saw them while I was working on my own avatar here that you're looking at, the 3D avatar, which is all in Unity before I switched over to Unreal Engine 5. So to say that the game's gonna be coming out like literally 2 years after pretty much getting out of college and starting up a company, I don't believe it. I think it's just a complete asset switch. So I'm not about it, especially if you're coming off, you know, saying there's a brand new game, this is everything that's gonna be involved in the game. So I'm not really interested. Maybe I'll do a video on it. I don't know. Maybe my mind will change. Maybe the assets are completely temporary, even though they said they're coming out this year, but I don't know. Anyways, those are my quick thoughts on Quinfall and why I haven't made a video on it. Anyways, getting back to Reign of Guilds, this is a brand new MMORPG that's going to be coming out this year. It's created by Atlant Games, and Grigori, who's the lead designer of the game, reached out to me at the end of January to kind of check out the game and see what I thought about it. They gave me a couple of Steam keys, and I did not get to try it out until literally yesterday, but the playtest was only for the starting island, kind of see how everything worked, if quests were working correctly, what can be adjusted and stuff like that, which is pretty cool because you don't really see that happening. But anyways, if you really want to know about Reign of Guilds, it is a first-person action MMORPG, although you can use third-person action by pressing the letter L on your keyboard, by the way. So the MMO menu and everything is really interesting because it reminds me of like ESO or something. I don't know why, it just does, even though I have like limited knowledge about ESO because I barely played it. So it's all about players coming first. So all the politics, the crafting, the trading, there's sieges, there's territorial wars and economic struggles and stuff like that. That is all available in the game. So it's all player-driven. Even the markets and the shops, whatever guild is kind of controlling that territory, they will be the ones that are collecting taxes, so they can set the taxes for 5%, 10%, stuff like that, which we've kind of seen in games like Arcage and the upcoming Ashes of Creation, and I think New World actually. So right now the playtest is over, you can't play it right now, but I do have a couple of keys for the game if anyone's interested that I will be giving away in this video. So he had reached out to me and gave me some information about the game, you know, telling me that the studio was pretty small, it was indie studio, which I love indie studios. I'm only giving you my first impressions and information based on the playtest that I did, which is only playtest number 2. So starting the game, I immediately found that the graphics were pretty nice. I mean, considering this is an indie studio, this was actually pretty good and on par with a lot of the modern MMOs and even RPGs that we start to play. The character creation was a little lacking, but you could adjust the character to look differently. But overall, I mean, I was pretty impressed considering, again, this is a small indie studio that's creating an MMORPG, right? So they've been keeping a low profile because they didn't really want to hype people up until things were kind of ready, right? So this year will be early access, and then they're trying to make sure that everything goes well. So the game currently has been in development for more than 5 years, which is what it takes to make an MMO, by the way. So the game will be open world PvP, but there are some limitations, like they don't want people just to kill absolutely everybody and create a gank box. That's what they said. We want to create an open world PvP game without a gank box. There are PvE elements as well in the open world, which affects everything. So as I started out, I thought I would be alone, to be perfectly honest. I wasn't really sure. I was thrown back by the first person stuff because I completely forgot that it was a first person MMORPG until later on that I figured I could just press the letter L and it would take me out of that. But anyways, I quickly adjusted into the first person mode, but I was actually enjoying it. The voice acting was pretty good, but actually what I was focusing on was the sound and the fact that they managed to create a spatial sound with the voices. So if someone's talking and they're behind me, it sounds like they're behind me from my headphones. If they're to my right, they're to my right. If I'm walking away, it feels like I'm literally walking away from the person that's speaking to me, or rather the NPC.
I must teach you the basics of combat and magic. Let's start with melee weapons. A short sword is at its best in a tight battle formation or a cramped space. It's also a perfect weapon against unarmored opponents. It will be of little use against heavy armor though, except for special attacks.
Graphically, again, it did remind me of ESO for some reason, or maybe it's just like my memory is a little charred. But maybe that or New World, I guess. It did remind me of that. I will say that the interaction with the quests was a little confusing at first, because sometimes you need to press the plus sign to go on to the next set of quests, which is not necessarily like intuitive for a lot of players, and people don't really necessarily look at that, but there are no signs or anything that tells you to do it, except a very small thing on the right side of your screen. So I feel like maybe if like the UI were to like freeze for a moment and kind of get dark and then show a big ass arrow to there, it's like press this button please, or like a pop-up or something, which you usually see in MMOs anyways, that would probably help quite a bit, because I know there were a lot of people, because I was in a room full of players and they were all trying to figure it out until somebody figured it out and they went upstairs while I was going downstairs and they had wrote in the general chat or whatever, and that's the only way they figured it out. And I literally didn't know what they were talking about until I got to that point and I remembered the plus sign. So the combat's really weird because it is action combat. So you can shoot anywhere, you can wherever you're aiming at. It's not tap target whatsoever. It's what you're looking at. That's not necessarily what I'm talking about. When it comes to the swords and stuff like that, it feels like chivalry. So if I'm using like a two-handed sword, it kind of feels like chivalry too if anyone's played that. Crossbow felt the exact same way, but what I found really cool and interesting that I have not seen in such a long time is the magic is not necessarily something like create a magic ball and shoot it at somebody. No, they're all these magic powders which you can buy in the world and stuff like that if you choose to go with that vocation. And each magic powder can do different things. They can create fire arrows, ice arrows, they can create healing magic for yourself or others, as well as cleanses and so on and so forth, which was really interesting because normally in an MMORPG what you do is you kind of learn it and that's it. This is a limited supply. This is something that you need to go and buy or craft yourself and then kind of keep it in your inventory and then put it on your hotbar and then use it. So I found that really, really interesting. I found that really cool. But this is where it got kind of cool, I think, because with the magic itself, for example, you can just shoot it at somebody or yourself, right? You could just use it. But if you press the right click, you can create like a focus meter, which is a quick time event. And if you aim at the right place, it can be even more effective than it would have been on its own. Anyways, that aside, for the classes, it's not your traditional MMORPG where you choose a class and you're stuck with it. With this, it's similar to the Elder Scrolls series. They literally just said that to me. Like, it's similar to that, which again, that's what I felt like the game kind of felt like. The game has 8 attributes. You have 4 types of physical and you have 4 types of magical. So for magical, you have like air, earth, fire, stuff like that, right? Physical, you have dexterity and so on and so forth. So depending on the weapon that you decide to go with, because you can go with any weapon you want. If you go with a club, let's say, it will increase your strength. If you are throwing fireballs all the time with the fireball spells, it will increase your fire attributes. Also, before I continue, I did find something really interesting when creating a character that I completely missed, is that if you go in and create a very tall character, it will show you an additional attribute of you being able to kind of hit at longer ranges, I suppose, because you are taller, whereas if you're shorter, it removes that range. So it's not necessarily like the old MMOs where if you're tall, you're tall, and if you're short, you're short. And it's also not like how Terra was at one point, where if you created the shortest Ellen, for example, you could just not hit them in PvP. But anyways, back to the classes. What they call them is vocations. These vocational schools all have different things. You can choose whatever you want. After becoming level 15, you get to decide which school you want to go with. So that vocation will give you extra bonuses or penalties to attributes, as well as give you additional vocational abilities or special items for your equipment. As of this moment, there are 14 vocations available in the game. 5 are magical, 5 are physical, and 4 are universal. So that means it kind of combines things. So for the physical, it's the Crusader, the Gladiator, Hunter, Steelmaster, and Weaponsmith. For the magical, there's the Archmage, the Druid, Enchanter, Inquisitor, and Necromancer. And finally, for the universal, there is the Assassin, the Barbarian, the Blacksmith, and the Thief. So for the skill tree, it's a little bit different. I didn't actually get to record this far because, again, the playtest was only for the particular starting island. When you want to grow into a vocation and you want to get like more powerful items or more powerful abilities, what you need to do instead of just kind of unlocking something is that you reach a certain level and you're gonna get a brand new unique quest for that vocation. Once you get that quest done, it will give you the powerful item or ability. In terms of upgrading and leveling, you have complete control on how you want to upgrade your character, whether it's only through PvE, only through PvP, or by crafting. Now, when I do say crafting, I do mean like there are going to be raw materials in the world that you need to extract. Once you extract them, you can use them to turn them into materials, and then usually that means you have to transport them to refineries, which will be in the open world where anybody can go over there, and you pay for the processing that it costs. costs. It's going to be usually really cheap, but if you want to kind of focus on this, you can. This reminds me of RuneScape. If anybody remembers using shears to cut off the wool from the sheep and then, you know, turning that over, whatever, going over to the lumber yard to do this and that. Kind of reminds me of that in some ways. Now, to create the item you want to, sometimes you need to kill monsters in order to get the recipe. And then that recipe will drop and you'll be able to craft it. So let's say you went out, did everything, you got the recipe for a sword. What's interesting about this is they call it a blank. So you create the sword and it becomes a blank sword or an unenchanted item. The sword can be used in combat, you can fight whatever, but over time, as you use it more and more and you find an enchantment item, you can enchant your sword, which requires an enchanter. Usually there's going to be a player or an NPC, and they're going to enchant your sword, which can give it, let's say, attributes of fire, ice, or maybe it's going to be just stronger in general. In terms of owning a home, I know people really enjoy that. You can go and buy real estate in the game if you want, you can buy a house, but while they're refining that idea, for now, what players can do is that if they find a tavern in the world, they can go and buy a room which only has a bed and a chest, and later on, as they refine this process, each of those taverns will actually be unique properties, which will have different things, different looks and stuff like that, which you will not be able to find in another tavern, for example. So if you really like one tavern, then there you go. And yeah, I mean, the rest is kind of just up in development, and it's going to be in early access the first half of 2023. Now again, I do have a couple of keys for this game. If anyone's interested, let me know in the comments below on why you like this type of game. I found it graphically really nice. When I was walking around and just looking, I was like, oh, this is actually pretty polished considering, you know, considering how small of a studio. And though I do think it does need a lot more polishing in the terms of the quests and stuff like that, the server structure was okay. It was kicking us out for a little bit because there were a lot of players trying to play at the same time, but I don't necessarily know how many people can fit in a server because there's the North American server, the Russian server, and I think I saw one other, but I'm not necessarily sure. I think I saw French. I'm not quite sure. So yeah, if you guys are interested, this game is called Reign of Guilds. It's available on Steam right now. You can wishlist it. I don't know when the next playtest will be, but I'm sure that it's going to be available for everybody. But yeah, special thanks to Atlant Games for reaching out to me about this game and sending me over a couple of keys for the game. And it's cool to see more and more MMORPGs come out rather than being in a drought like we were for a long time. But anyways, let me know in the comments below if you guys are interested in this game, and we'll talk about it there. All right, guys, thanks for watching. Make sure to subscribe and click that adorable f***ing bell to know when I upload a brand new video. And don't forget to come join my Discord if you want to chat and hang out. Much love, and as always, till next time, friends.